Hi, welcome to ChemSimplified. I'm Dr. K, and in this video, we'll go through how to write formula for ionic compounds. We will use 5 examples involving monoatomic and polyatomic ions to illustrate crossover method. Before we begin, here are some commonly used ions. Notice that group 1 metals have plus 1 charge, group 2 metals has plus 2 charge, group 3 has plus 3, and group 5A elements, they form anions, specifically negative 3 charge, group 6, negative 2, and group 7, negative 1. And here are some of the commonly used polyatomic ions. Most of them are negatively charged except for ammonium, which is NH4+. Like I've mentioned at the beginning, we are going to use crossover method. So our first example is sodium sulfide. So the cation for sodium is Na+, and for sulfide is S2-. And we don't write out our 1, but because I'm going to demonstrate how we use crossover method, I'm going to write in the 1 so it becomes easier to imagine. So now let's cross over. I'll bring the 1 over to the other side, onto the sulfur side. And I'll do the same for the 2. The 2 on top of sulfur, I'll cross over down to Na. So what we do now is we write out the formula, which is Na2S1. But because we don't write out the 1, our formula for ionic compound sodium sulfide is Na2S. Let's move on to the second example, magnesium oxide. So magnesium is Mg2+, oxide is O2-. So we do the same thing, cross over, and the formula will be Mg2O2. And notice that we have 2 for Mg and 2 for O, and these two numbers can be simplified. So we're going to divide them by 2, and our final answer would actually be MgO. Next, lead 4 oxide. Lead 4 is Pb4+, oxide same, O2-, so we do the same thing, cross over, and that gives us Pb2O4. Recall earlier, the second example, we had to simplify. Well, it's the same case here. Because we have 2 and 4 for the subscript, we can divide the two numbers by 2, and that will give us PbO2. All the three examples that we've worked on, those involve monoatomic ion. The next two examples, I'm going to show you how we use the crossover method involving polyatomic ion. So let's move on to our fourth example, aluminum sulfate. So aluminum is Al3+, sulfate is SO42-. So we do the same method, which is cross over the charges and write it out. So we have Al2, SO4, and then there's a 3, right? Notice that I just inserted the bracket. The bracket is necessary because when I crossed the 3 from aluminum over to SO4, it meant 3 units of SO4. So that means I need to somehow indicate that I have 3 of the SO4, and that's where the bracket comes in. Otherwise, if I don't have the bracket, it would read Al2SO43, and that's ridiculous because it doesn't exist. So don't forget to put in that bracket, okay? Let's move on to the last one, the final example, calcium carbonate. Calcium is Ca2+, carbonate is CO32-. So we do the crossover again, and that gives us Ca2CO32, because there are 2 of it, so we put the bracket. Now, look at the subscripts. We have 2 and 2, so that means we need to further simplify them and divide that by 2, so that will give us CaCO3. Notice I just removed the bracket because now we only have 1 unit of CO3. There is no need to put in the bracket. So the formula for calcium carbonate is CaCO3. I've shown you 5 examples using this crossover method, and I'm sure you've already nailed this. In the event you want to go a little bit deeper, as in figuring out how the charges are formed, how to determine if they are ionic compound, how to name them, you can do all that in 1 hour. I have actually created a course in Udemy. It's titled Ionic Compound, Formula and Naming. I'm offering this course for free for a limited time, so be sure to click on there and head over there and sign up. It's very easy. So click on that link. I'll put it in the description box below as well. Once you click on the link, it will bring you to this page and click on that Enroll Now button. And once you click on that, it will prompt you to sign up or sign in. If you have an account already, just go ahead and log in. If you don't, it's super easy to sign up. Just put in your full name and email address that works and a password. And once you've done that, it will bring you immediately to the course and you can start. There are videos and resources available. Once you've gone through the course and if you find it helpful, I would really appreciate it if you could leave me your honest feedback. So that ends our video on writing formula for ionic compound. I hope you find them helpful. As usual, do subscribe if you still haven't done so. I'll be uploading new videos every weekend, so watch out for them. If you wish to get more info or practice questions, do head over to ChemSimplified.com. You will find blog posts and practice questions to test your skills. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.